By the end of this video, you're going to understand what Dumpling AI is, how powerful it is, and how you can use it to automate just about everything inside of your business. This is a sponsored video from Dumpling AI, but we only create videos with tools that we think are insanely valuable and are going to actually be tools that you want to use in your business and tools that we would use ourselves. So I'm really excited to show you what Dumpling AI is capable of. Let's get into it. Here we are in the Dumpling AI dashboard, and I'm going to quickly show you around so you can see what's possible and how it works. So on the left side, we have a couple important tabs that you need to know about. First is API keys. So you're going to need to generate an API key to connect it with Make or Zapier, which we're going to do later on. We also have an easy way to see all of the usage, which is nice to see kind of a log of everything that you've done. You can also change your settings and delete the project as well if needed. And you can make multiple projects with different API keys, different agents, etc. We have knowledge bases, so you can add information for your agents to get knowledge from. So here I just added a test. I just uploaded the constitution, but you can upload anything. And let's say, you know, your company is related to taxes and you want to upload the tax law, for example, or all the tax documents that the IRS provides. That would be one example of something that you could upload to your knowledge base. And then here, which I'm personally most excited about, are the AI agents. And this is kind of a game changer for using tools like Make or Zapier. And I'm going to show you just an example of how it works. And then we're going to build our own, and we'll build it within Make so that you can actually see how you can integrate it into your own workflow. But just as an example, I'm going to click into an agent that I already created. And when you have an agent in Dumpling AI, you just give it a name, you give it a description. So here I said a helpful agent who is an expert researcher. And then you have description now, or the instructions of what you want the agent to do. And then you have tools you're going to give that agent so that it has specific tools to actually complete those tasks. Now, for the instructions, what I found really helpful was instead of writing all of this out by myself, what you can do is click this generate button, have it generate a prompt. And I typed something as simple as, I want to get the name, website, and email of the local business businesses in the industry and city that I say. So I literally just typed this, very, very similar to this prompt. You click generate. And then it gives you this very detailed prompt that's optimized for the AI agent to work correctly. So if we open it up a little bit, you can see it's going to find the name, website, URL, and contact email for a local business, give it its city and type. So first, it's going to identify potential businesses, locate the website, extract information, and verify information. And then it's going to output it in a specific JSON format. And it's going to return it as an array. And then it does a good job as well. If no website is found, return not found, etc. And then for tools, the way that this works is you can add up to 10 tools per agent. So if you open this up, you can see all of the tools that you have available to you. In our case, I added the search Google places, so it can search for places and businesses. I also added get Google reviews, which I don't think it's using right now, but I could say, hey, also give me the, maybe I'll add that, get the number of, get the Google review rating, for example, or we might be able to try a different agent in the future where we want to, you know, find coffee shops that have Wi-Fi and search the reviews for that. So that's just an idea of something that you could do. And then I also have scrape URL so that we can scrape the URL of the business website that it finds from Google Places. So then to test out your agent, all you do is on the right side, you message your agent. So it's as simple as saying, restaurants in San Francisco, California. So what you do is I sent it that message. And the reason all I had to do is send it that is because I said I was going to give a city and type. So what it's doing first, and it's telling you what it's doing, what the agent is doing is first it's going to search places. So search for places and businesses using Google Places. And we can see here it found about 10 places. And we can see it found the website for these places. You can see the websites that it found. And then now what it's going to do is it's thinking further. And what I believe it's doing is scraping. So we can see actually it's calling scrape URL. So scrape URL, it's calling that to get the information. So here, as we go down, we can see it found the name, the website, but not an email for most of these. Let's see. So for these, it actually didn't find the email, which is interesting. I did it in a different city and it was able to find about six of the emails. This is going to be dependent on whether the website has the email available, because it's going to scrape the website. It's either going to have the email or not have the email. So let's say, why don't we do another test real quick just to see how it works. Let's say restaurants in Chicago, Illinois. And I'm just wondering what will happen if I say find 20. So let's see what happens if I ask for more. I'm going to pause the video. Let's let it search and I'll unpause it once it's done. Okay, so we're back. It finished the work and it actually did find 20, which is kind of awesome. I wasn't totally sure if it was going to do that. I wonder what the limits of that would be. We could keep trying and testing it out. And if we go down, we can see it was able to find emails for some of these local businesses. And this is kind of awesome. If you've ever tried to sell to local businesses before, it is very tedious to find this information. And even if it's only able to find, you know, half of them or 25% of them, that still saves a ton of time because that's giving you a great base of leads to sell to. We could potentially have it try to find like the business owner's information. We could add more tools such as Google search to try to find the business owner, for example, the first name, things like that for lead enrichment. But overall, I think this is really great and I'm really impressed with it. So before we get into connecting to Make and kind of how you can use Dumpling within other workflows, I want to show you how you could use this agent just as a standalone tool. So if we go to share, you can change this to either be unpublished, only me, or anyone with the link. And you can even embed this as an iframe into another website. The embed feature is really interesting because that means you could have a, you know, lead generation website where you just embed this and maybe someone has to enter their email to get access to this tool for free. So you could potentially use this as like a lead generation tool, which is pretty interesting. If we click on the share link, when I update it to anyone with link, we can open it in a new tab. This is what it looks like. So it's just like a nice little chat. And then just like what we did before, we could say, you know, please find me. Why don't we say plumbers in, let's say, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. So it's going to be thinking. And just like it did before, it's going to kind of tell us exactly what it's doing, which is very cool. And I'm going to pause the video and then I'll come back once it's finished so you don't have to watch it search. And here we go. We got our results. And looks like here it was able to find emails for about half of these plumbing companies. Yeah, that it was able to find. So pretty cool that you're able to also use these agents as kind of standalone links if you wanted to do that. And I think some use cases would lend itself a little bit better for that than others. Now, let me jump into another agent really quickly, just so you can see kind of the variety of things that you can build. So I built this agent here, which is a trade rumor journalist, a sports journalist. And what I did was basically gave it the tool of searching perplexity. What's great about this tool is it's able to find real-time information. What I really like about Dumpling is that I can just easily add this functionality. Now, yes, I could connect to the Perplexity API myself and build a workflow in Make or Zapier, have it search Perplexity, use that information to write the blog post. But I really like how here it's just so easy that I can just add this search Perplexity tool and then it has it. And then for the instructions, this could be kind of built out further, of course, but these are the instructions. And then one other thing I wanted to, and then here we're going to ask it to do it for a specific sports team. And then I'm just going to show you the advanced settings real quick under model. Either it's going to be auto, or you can specifically choose either GPT-4o mini or 4o. And I wonder if in the future they're going to let you choose even more types of models. But right now, those are the options that they give you. And then also, we can hide tool usage from end users. So what this says is when enabled, tool usage will only be visible to you or your project team. End users will not see the tools and only see the final responses. So that's kind of when we tested it. And you, because I was the admin of the account, it showed me the tools, but you could turn that on or off. Start conversation with form. That's actually really interesting. I'm going to add that for this example here. So let's add a form field. This is going to be team name. And then enter team to get trade rumors. Perfect. Okay. And then let's go ahead and click save agent. So what this agent does is if we enter a team name, it's going to give us an article of trade rumors. So let's say we want to do New York Knicks. So we'll start the chat. And basically what that did was it just kind of fills that out for the user, which is also, I think, very helpful if other people are using your agent. And then here we go. It's search perplexity. And here are the latest trade rumors. We have interest in Kyrie Irving, front court options. Here's recent trades and adjustments that they made. So pretty cool. And you could do that for any team. And you could think about all sorts of different types of use cases here. For searching perplexity and having it spit out information using that perplexity tool. So this is an example of just using one tool. And the first one we did used multiple tools. So it just depends on the agent that you want to build. So here we are at Make. Before we end this video, I'm going to show you what's possible using Dumpling AI in make.com. And then in future videos, I'm going to show you how to start from scratch and build really complex real world use cases using Dumpling AI and Make. So be sure to subscribe to our channel to get our future Dumpling AI videos. So here in Make, if you're not familiar with Make, it's very similar to Zapier, where you can build workflows visually. So here we have a trigger of just watching new rows in a Google Sheet, just so I can show you what's possible here with Dumpling AI. And then here, if you once you connect Dumpling AI, which is as simple as getting that API key that I showed you before, entering it into Make, and then it's connected. Here are all of the actions that Dumpling AI has available to you. So first, we have our AI agent completion. This allows us to connect to any of those AI agents that we just created and then give us the result. So basically, instead of kind of having that chat, we're going to have the input from whatever our trigger is, put that into the agent and get a result, and then use that result in something else. So that's super powerful, something we're going to be using later on. Then we have all of these individual functions. So such as generating an image with Flux, searching with a knowledge base, getting the relevant results, getting a YouTube transcript, crawling a website, searching Google Maps, searching Google Places, parsing data. There's a lot more: converting PDF to text, converting document to text, running code, trimming videos, etc. Now, what I really like about this is it replaces a lot of other API calls that you would have to make and integrate, and it's going to save you a lot of time. So could you connect directly to the Flux, kind of to a Flux API separately? Yes, that's definitely possible, but just having it all in one with Dumpling is really, really nice, even if you're not using the AI agent functionality. Of course, the AI agent functionality gives you that extra kind of functionality that is even more than just using these other APIs, because it's going to be able to call them together. RAG, this is going to replace having to use something like Pinecone, which allows you to kind of create these knowledge bases and search. But again, Dumpling AI allows you to do that on your own. Things like getting a YouTube transcript. This is something I've actually done with another API, with a tool that I built called BlogFox, which basically converts YouTube videos to blog posts. So if you're interested, go to blogfox.ai for automating SEO for your YouTube channel, or just in general, if you want to bulk generate blog posts. But here, getting YouTube transcripts right here from Dumpling AI is just a really helpful API call. And I would say the same for a lot of these as well. So if you wanted to select one, you would just select the one that you wanted, and then it's going to have all of the kind of parameters that you need to fill out for whatever option you chose. So these are all the options you would need to choose for the image. So let's say the image, I want to say prompt an image of a baseball field. Doesn't really matter right now. I'm going to leave everything else as the default. And then what I'm going to do is right click, run this module only. And just to show you kind of how it works here to see the result. So here we go. We got the result. We'll go to the output and let's click on copy that and open it. And here we go. Just from that simple prompt, we got this image of a baseball field. All right, I'm going to stop there. Hopefully by now you have a good overview of what Dumpling AI is capable of, how powerful it is, how powerful the agents are starting to think about some use cases that you could use for yourself. If you're interested in using Dumpling AI, check the link in our description. Subscribe to our channel to get our future Dumpling AI videos right here. We're going to go into a lot more detail, building some really complex AI agents and workflows, and show you how powerful this is and how you can automate a lot of things inside of your business. Also, check the link in our description to go to No Code MBA if you want to learn even more about building with AI and no code tools. Leave a comment below if you have any questions, and I'll see you in the next video.